بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. قال رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Welcome to the LMA Arabic lessons in which we will learn Arabic, and our niyyah should be to understand the Quran al-Kareem and the Ahadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directly from his original text, to be inspired by it. We're going to have the incidental approach and a direct approach without grammar in order to get familiar with the vocabulary first. And most important in Arabic is vocabulary. If we know the words, we can construct sentences, we can use the sentences, and we can understand the language. Please be with me and bear with us, and just repeat after me, and you will see the words developing. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The first word we're going to learn, and which is the most important word in the Arabic language or in any language, is the word ana. Ana, repeat with me again. Ana. We don't read the alif, we don't say ana, we say ana. Ana, once more, the word ana. Ana means I. I am the most important person, therefore you have to know me first. So ana. Now, just to make a sentence with it, it's quite easy. For instance, my name is Khalid. So I will put ana Khalid. Ana Khalid. Together, ana Khalid. Or in heaven, our notes here, ana Salim. Or you can use your own name, ana Zahir, or ana Musa, or ana Parvez. Whatever you want to use, you can use with the word ana. So the word is ana. The names are all different, and that will continue, whether male or female. You can say ana Khadija, ana Saida. We'll come to that just now. So the first word we learn is ana. And ana means I. I'm sure we are okay with that. And just repeat once or twice with me again the word ana. Ana, ana Khalid, ana Salim, ana Parvez, ana Musa, ana Muhammad. I'm sure we are okay with that repetition. And the second word, which is the most important as well, is the word anta. Anta. I'm sure you're guessing the word anta. It was ana before, and the second word we have is anta. Together, when we speak Arabic or when we use Arabic, we don't use tajweed. Tajweed is only with Quran. We won't say anta. That sounds very funny. But we'll say anta. And I'm sure you understand anta ya means it's a very easy word. The next person after I is you. So you, anta, you. Again, anta, 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 you. It depends who you're speaking to. If I'm speaking to Rashid, so I will say anta Rashid. Or I can say anta Saeed. Or I can say anta Ahmed. Anta Rashid. Anta Rashid. Anta Ayyub. I can use whoever I'm speaking to, I will say anta, and then the name that comes with it. So ana was I, and anta is you. Ana, once more, just have a look at it. It's foreign, it's the first time we're doing it. So ana is for I, and anta is for you. Ana, I, anta, you. Again, ana, anta. Will you repeat with me? Ana, anta. Once more, ana, anta. Okay, yeah, we distinguish, the Arabs are very particular of gender. So there's no mixing of genders here. There's no unisex type of a thing. So anta will be for a male. Anta will be for a male. So anta Rashid. You can't say anta Khadija. It won't sound right in Arabic, and it's not correct. So the first word we learned was ana, and the second word that we are learning now is anta, and you use it with a name as well. So we've got two words here already. One is ana, and the second one was anta. And I just write it on the side here again, just to get the word ana and anta. Right. Now the next word is quite easy. It's quite similar. And we're going to say anti. Here was anta. And here we have anta. And here we're going to have anti. So anti in English is quite common. Anti means you're talking to a feminine. So anti will be for a feminine. And we can say anti and they put a name next to it. Anti Saida. Anti Saida. So anta was Rashid. Anti would be Saida. Or anti Khadija. Anti Firouza. Anti Hafsa. Anti Juwayriya. We can use any name with it. So Anna is I. Anta is you, masculine, and here it'll be you, feminine. I'm sure you got it. It's quite easy. Three words. Shouldn't take longer than that. Anna is I. Anta is you. Anti also is you. In English, both yous are the same. But in Arabic, for a male, you say anta, and for a female, you say anti. Are we okay? If you look here on the lesson here, at Darsul Awwal, that means the first lesson. And I'm sure you are comfortable now with me to learn Arabic the very easy way is Ana Salim, Anta Saeed, Anti Saeeda. Can you repeat one more time? Ana Salim, Anta Saeed, Anti Saeeda. So get the words, and as you are learning Quran as well, this will help you to identify words. And because they are names, they are quite easy for us to understand. I'm sure we are quite comfortable with the first lesson now. Jazakallah for being with us, and I'm sure you learn three words and you'll be so happy to know it. And in the next lesson we'll do furthermore and we'll build our vocabulary. Jazakumullah. Assalamu alaikum.